Hello everyone. In this video I will change the version of the Juniper X2200 switch from version 15 to version 12. Boot up the device, you need to use the console cord to manipulate the internal interface. Right-click on Windows, click on Computer Management, check the serial number port plugged into the computer. My serial port USB is COM9. You can use any software to get inside the device, in the video I use MobaxDerm. So I have access to the device via the serial number port COM9. By default initial configuration, the username will be root and there is no password set. To enter device configuration mode, type CLI. This is the initial default configuration of the device. You will see that the device is currently version 15.1. To display the version details of the device, type show ver. To download other versions, go to support.juniper.net/support/downloads and select the version you want. I downloaded the update of version 12 earlier, now I will replace this version into the switches. According to Juniper's policy, you cannot download one easily, you need to contact a partner or distributor to download. In this video, I will update the version for switches using FTP. Type show interface term to check the IP address on the ports. Now I will configure the IP address on the GE0000 port. I will set the address for the port to 192.168.1.1. My device is the default configuration, so I need to set a password for the root user before I can commit. I have successfully committed, and now I will configure the IP set for the laptop with the address 192.168.1.2. So so my computer was able to connect to the switch via the GE0000 port. You will need to install WinSCP to transfer files inside the device via FTP protocol. You can access wincp.net to download the appropriate version to your computer. To be able to transfer files inside the device, create one new FTP site and enter the IP address on the switch port with a username and password. If the root user is inaccessible, try creating a new user on Juniper EX2200. I will create a new user as Dotiendung with super user permissions. Don't forget to create a password for it. After the commit has been successful, I will try logging in with a new user on WinSCP. Not yet. I need to configure the FTP service on the device to allow external devices to access the inside using the FTP service. Type the command set system services FTP, and then type commit to save. To check if the device has enabled FTP service, use CMD and type the command telnet 192.168.1.1 port 21. Now I can transfer files inside the EX2200 using WinSCP software. I will drag the firmware version 12 file into the Avara TMP path of the device. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video with beginner engineers. I transferred the file inside the device successfully. Now I will update it to work with this version. You can check the list of files in TMP with the command run file list var TMP. Use the command run request system software add var TMP your file name and type no validate to not validate the file. The device will update faster, and type reboot to have the device restart after the update has been successful. The update speed of the device is fast or slow, it depends on the processor of the switch and the size of the file. You can skip to the end of the video. After 30 minutes of updating, the device updated successfully now. You can log into the device and check its new configuration and version. The device has successfully updated from version 15.1 to version 12.3. The configuration of the device is not changed, but you should backup the old configuration before updating the device to the new version. The video ends here, don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment below. Thanks for watching the whole video.